Today, we're going to read Romans chapters 9 through 11. In the first 8 chapters, Paul has focused a lot on the Gentiles and their acceptance by God into the church. But he wants to make sure that his fellow Jews understand God still loves them just as much as he always has. The problem is, most of the Jews rejected Jesus as the Messiah, and so refused to part ways with the law of Moses and embrace Christianity, which is the fulfillment of the law. Romans 9 through 11 deals with this thorny problem. How can we account for the predominant rejection of Jesus by the Jewish people? In chapter 9, Paul explains that the Jews have always had a special relationship with God, and they still do. But this relationship with him is no longer through the law of Moses, because Jesus has fulfilled that law by dying on the cross. God chose the descendants of Abraham through Isaac and Jacob to be his special covenant people. But the Jews, for the most part, have rejected Jesus. That's why you see in the book of Acts, Paul going to synagogues, and while many of the Gentile proselytes accepted Jesus as their Savior, many of the Jews in those same synagogues flatly rejected him, and then turned their ire toward Paul and persecuted him. In Romans chapter 10, Paul makes the argument that the Old Testament anticipated the arrival of the gospel and its acceptance by so many non-Jews, that is, Gentiles. Paul quotes passages from all major sections of the Old Testament, including the prophets, the Psalms, and from Moses in the book of Deuteronomy. I want you to see the two quotes that close out chapter 10. The first one is from Moses, from Deuteronomy 32, verse 21. I will make you, the Jewish nation, I will make you jealous of those who are not a nation. He's talking about the Gentiles. And then in Isaiah 65, verse 1, God said, I have been found by those who did not seek me. I have shown myself to those who did not ask for me. Again, the Gentiles have found God. From these passages, Paul tells his fellow Jews that they should not at all be surprised that the Gentiles accepted the gospel. What should surprise us, and it surprised Paul to no end, is that the Jews rejected Jesus out of hand and failed to see how he is the fulfillment of the law of Moses, the Old Testament. What Paul is saying is, it's not about ethnicity anymore. You're not God's people because of your race, but because of your faith in Christ, your loyalty to him as your Savior. He uses an illustration in chapter 11. Israel is compared to an olive tree. It is firmly planted and has numerous branches, but many of these branches have been cut off. These are the Jewish people who refuse to believe the gospel and accept Jesus. In their place, Gentiles who believe were grafted in. Here's the danger, though. Gentiles might start getting all arrogant because they're now in God's favor, but they could just as easily be cut off too. It's time to set aside pride, God says, and all be united. We are all saved by grace. God fulfilled the law by sending Jesus. This was his plan all along. The Old Testament promises haven't been broken in Jesus. They have been fulfilled in Jesus. But he doesn't end this section, chapters 9 through 11, on a negative. Can I read the closing verses with you? Here's Romans 11, verses 33 through 36. I love these verses. Oh, the depth of the riches of the wisdom and knowledge of God! How unsearchable his judgments and his paths beyond tracing out! Here, Paul quotes from the Old Testament. Who has known the mind of the Lord, or who has been his counselor? Who has ever given to God that God should repay them? And then, here's how Paul ends this middle section of Romans. For from him and through him and for him are all things. To him be the glory forever. Amen. As you read Romans 9 through 11 today, I hope you can hear Paul's desperate pleas for his ethnic brothers and sisters to accept Jesus as the Messiah. It breaks his heart that so many of them won't, but he rejoices over all those who have.